Blue Jackets versus Tampa Bay, the sequel. Fresh off the four-game sweep in playoffs last season, this time is certainly gonna be different between these two teams here in the first round of playoffs. No Duchesne, no Panarin, a big loss for the Blue Jackets offensively. They no longer have their goaltender in Sergei Bobrovsky. You look at Tampa Bay, there's questions around Steven Stamkos playing. Coach Cooper already said there's not gonna be any further updates on Steven Stamkos until he is ready to play. You have Hedman that was in that ugly or scary looking play where he twisted his ankle over the weekend, but again, not much of an update at the moment on if he's going to be able to play. You would assume by the, you know, his reaction and the way it looked, he's probably not going to, but again, we don't know until we get further information. Those are big players on both sides that could potentially not be in this series. And there's just so many different factors that are going to play into this game. One of the things, I don't know if we're going to hear much of it talked about, but I think it could matter, is the fact that the Blue Jackets just came out of playing actual games, meaningful games. Meanwhile, Tampa Bay is coming out of this round robin where I ain't going to say Tampa Bay was one of these teams, but there was quite a few teams that treated this as preseason, treated it as dress rehearsal. So they didn't want to take the chance of getting players injured. And now Tampa's learning exactly why that was the case. You know, there was the Dallas's, that Washington game on Sunday. It couldn't have been any more, or not Washington, it was St. Louis and Dallas, I think it was. That, you know, bland game those two teams played. Those 0-2 teams, they had nothing to play for, literally nothing to play for. Those 0-2, they could care less if they won. But there was a lot of that. There was a lot of that in these round robin games where teams were like, we'd rather bench or not play our good players as much. We'd rather play a little bit more conservative. Seeding's not as important to us as actually going out and having a healthy roster. And you have to wonder if teams are ready. You have to wonder if they're going to be a slow. They're going to be a step behind there for a period or a shit or whatever it is, trying to get used to the flow of the game, unlike the Blue Jackets or any other playing team for that matter, who's coming fresh out of playing four or five games, and they're playing at their fullest pedal to the metal right now. We'll see. We'll see if there's any sort of impact there. But I think the number one key for the Blue Jackets, it's going to be, easily said, putting up enough goals. The offense disappeared on multiple occasions versus Tampa or Toronto, a team that was statistically speaking the worst defense in all of the playoffs, finishing ranked 25th, allowing 3.17 goals per game. Not to mention, it was Jake Muzzin that went down. It was arguably one of, if not their best defensive, you know, player in their defensive zone. And then you've seen the Blue Jackets, what, game five, they was down two defensemen. There was only four guys on the ice there for a bit that were D-men for the Toronto Maple Leafs, and still the Blue Jackets ended up, you know, they put up two goals, they put up three at the end of it, and we did see, you know, one of those goals as a result probably of a little bit of sloppy D play there. But again, you want to see them start picking teams apart. It start with Toronto. You wonder how this Blue Jacket offense will transition when they have to start playing teams that are a lot better defensively. And I'm looking at some of these young guys for Columbus. Foodie, he looked really nice. He looks like he could be, you know, a spark for this offense going forward. Texier played a big role in that Tampa series last postseason. He could very well do it again. He's been playing pretty well at PLD lately. We'll see. I think the pieces are there for this Blue Jackets offense to put some goals up. You know, you got Bjorkstrand, who is pointless still. Another guy, when he gets streaky, he plays very well. The defense right now is driving this offense, as it has a lot of the times this year. But I think this Blue Jackets offense, it's got the capabilities. There's plenty of players on this team that can start putting pucks on net and putting them into the back of the net and helping this Blue Jackets team win games. But all in all, I think it's just going to be the same story as Toronto. Defense versus offense once more. This time around, though, you have to think, well, Vasilevsky is probably going to perform a little bit better than Freddie B. And Vasilevsky's been up there in the Vezina talks for a couple years in a row now, playing outstanding back there. Then again, though, Vasilevsky last season had an .856 save percentage against these Blue Jackets in the postseason. So Vasilevsky, maybe it's a Russian thing. We see it with Bobrovsky quite often here in Columbus, now in Florida, you know, struggles in playoffs. Will Vasilevsky be able to get over that this time around? We'll see. You had Hedman, who struggled last season, but there was talk that he wasn't completely healthy, which again will be an interesting one this time around if he plays not completely healthy once again. And there's no question about it, if you're Columbus, you gotta force Tampa to play your game if you want to win this series, and you got to continue to see that solid goaltending. Merzlikins and Korpisalo both playing very good in that Toronto series, keeping those scores low. A big reason they continued on here. You look past the meltdown that Merzlikins had in that final 4 minutes. He played outstanding. He played outstanding the game before when he came in relief, and he played outstanding the first 3.5 periods of that game. It was unfortunate that he got a little shaken up there at the end, but you gotta tip your cap off for the guy and realize he played really good back there. So it'll be interesting, because the good goaltending duo, even though it's scary to do musical chairs back there with your goalies, it's really deadly in playoffs. It really is. When you look at these teams that have had multiple good goalies and just at the flip of the switch, you can throw the other one in, go with the hot hand. We've seen it with Washington, really. That 1 year they won the Stanley Cup. Grubauer started the series. We remember, again, Blue Jacket, we remember it. We was there. They brought Grubauer and he struggled. They brought Holtby and he just carried him all the way there. We've seen the same with, you know, the Binnington story last season. That wasn't playoffs. That was January. But to have that ability to just go in there, flip the switch, really, you know, it jolts the offense, jolts the defense a little bit. You bring in that other goalie and he's just as good as a starter. That can be a big weapon for these Blue Jackets. But if you're Tampa, there's no chance they forget last season, right? The ultimate chip on your shoulder going into the next season is going in there thinking about having a historic season, getting swept in the first round. Embarrassing. There's no way they forget about that. And you get a chance to redeem yourself this year against the very same team in the first round. I gotta think these Tampa Bay Lightning are gonna come out and are gonna come out fire and hot right here. But again, you look at it, if Hedman can't go, guys got to step up over there. They have talent back there. You know, they got Sergachev, they got Shattenkirk, they got McDonough. These guys have to step up and play big roles in slowing down this Columbus Blue Jackets offense and keeping the games low scoring for these Tampa Bay Lightning. Because again, it'll probably be a low scoring, grinding affair between these two again. And again, Vasilevskiy, though, if he's playing like Vezina winning Vasilevskiy, injuries are not on this Tampa Bay Lightning team, it's going to be very hard for the Columbus Blue Jackets to put up goals. You could expect a lot of 2-1, 1-0, 2-3 games here. That could really go either way. And that's the thing with this Tampa Bay Lightning. They have so many heavy hitters everywhere on this team. Even without Stamkos, Kucherov has proven time and time again how good he is without anybody around him. You still got Vasilevskiy back there to help bail out that defense if they do struggle. But I do think the major key here for both teams, much like the series with Toronto for Columbus, is getting out ahead early. And as mentioned, you know, Tampa just came in off these dress rehearsal type games for many teams. Will they be slow at the gate? Will they come out firing on all cylinders? Not to mention, you cannot allow these two or these guys to walk in without two of their four best players and allow them to get their footing, allow them to take game number one. The amount of confidence that will instill into that team, into that locker room, if they can go out there, down a couple men, coming off the round robin games, coming off of, you know, that 4-game sweep and say, guess what? Here we are, up 1-0. Put the foot on the throttle and go. It could be a short series for the Columbus Blue Jackets. On the other hand, Blue Jackets come out 1-0 lead, and Toronto's once again, or Tampa Bay's once again questioning how they're going to do without these players on the ice. Is Vasilevskiy going to struggle again? Are they fearsome of yet another 4-game sweep? It'll be a tough affair nonetheless. We're going to say Blue Jackets in 6.